So if you deal with chronic foot or ankle pain, Achilles tendon, plantar fascia, maybe you've rolled your ankle more than once. You can't figure out what the heck is going on. Why does my feet and ankles always have problems? Well, the answer may not be your foot and ankle. It may be something that you're completely overlooking. And today we're gonna talk about exactly what that may be. So when we're looking at chronic foot and ankle pain, we have to realize that the foot and ankle don't work alone. If they did, that'd be a really inefficient system. We look how big our body is, and then we look at how small our foot and ankle are. And so we have to realize that the foot and ankle are a small piece of a big structure that all works together, and that is our entire leg. So when we are propelling ourselves through space, right? Walking, jogging, running and tumbling, dancing, all those things, when we are moving our body forward, this entire structure is working together. Our hip is the biggest, most strongest joint in the body, and it should be doing most of this work. So if we look at our hip all the way down through the leg and down all the way to the big toe, all these things should be working together. If the hip is off and the hip is not doing its job, what that says to the foot and ankle is, well, I still have to go forward, so let me use these structures more. We'll carry more of the workload, essentially. And so in this video today, we're going to look at how a tight hip and a weak glute or a weak butt, how they can actually create problems down the river for our foot and ankle. And by addressing the hip, we effectively fix the problem up top that takes load off of the foot and ankle and can help to get rid of some of the chronic foot and ankle pain that you have. So the hip joint is a ball and socket joint, meaning that there's a big cup and a bone that sits inside and it moves all the way around. It should be one of the most mobile joints in our body. If our hip becomes stiff and that joint is not moving as well as it should, then what happens is everything else around it has to take up that workload. So the first thing we're gonna talk about is how we can open up our hip or create more flexibility to the hip joint so that the hip can take more of that motion so we don't send it further down. The first stretch we're gonna show you is called a couch stretch or a hip opener. To perform this stretch, you're going to find a flat surface that you're gonna put your foot up against. From there, you're going to put the shin and foot flush against the wall and you're going to lean back into your heel. If this is enough of a stretch, perfect, stop right there and hold that stretch. If we feel like we can have more of a stretch there, what we want to do is bring the leg up into a lunge position and try to drive our upper body all the way up. Now, the important thing to remember here is we want to make sure we're not arching way far with our back, because then it becomes an abdominal stretch, and that's not our goal. We want to make sure that we're keeping our torso tight and we're really thinking of driving the hip forward. The stretch you should feel will be in the front of the upper thigh, and it should be from the upper thigh down to about mid-thigh. If we start to get a sensation up into the abdomen, we're arching too far with our back. Now for this stretch, this is something that we want to do every day for a minimum of 60 seconds. If you have extra time that you can dedicate to it, up to 90 seconds would be ideal. And that's gonna help to open up the front of the hip where most people are much tighter than they realize. I know a lot of times cheerleaders can do splits, but being able to do a split and having a true flexible hip flexor are completely different things. So with the couch stretch, we make sure we perform that every single day. So the muscle that works against the hip flexor is our glute max, or our big glute muscle, our big butt muscle. All muscles in the body have a muscle that works against it, right? So we think about our arm as a very common area that we see that. So we know our bicep bends our elbow and our tricep straightens our elbow. So when our bicep works, our tricep has to relax. When our tricep works, the bicep has to relax. So the reason for that is we can't bend and straighten at the same time. One has to do the job and the other has to let that muscle do its job. Same thing happens at the hip. The glute max, our big glute muscle, is the opposite for our hip flexor. The hip flexor closes the hip, the glute max opens the hip. So because of that, we usually will find a glute max weakness in our cheer athletes. For this, we can really activate and start to strengthen the glute max with some simple exercises. The first thing we're gonna have you guys do is just a standing hip extension. All you do is stand, brace your core again, so we make sure we take the lower back out and we're focusing mostly on the hip. And from here, we're just gonna simply drive the foot behind us. When that becomes easy, we're gonna add resistance. We can add a light band to help to, again, add resistance to this movement and strengthen the glute. And then our last set of exercises we're gonna do is a bridge series. Now with this, we can start with 2 feet laying flat on the ground, bracing with our core, lifting the hips or lifting the butt. And then as this becomes easy again, all we would do is just switch to one leg. Now by opening the front of the hip and also strengthening the glute, we're allowing the hip to be a more functional part of propelling us forward, which is gonna take off a lot of work on the foot and ankle. So if you have chronic foot or ankle pain and you realize no matter what you've done, it won't go away, stretching and all that kind of stuff is still not going away, try these two exercises to see if you can deload that area and give it some help. Hey guys, if you found this video useful, give me a thumbs up and leave your comments below. Let me know if you've been having chronic foot or ankle pain because we want to make sure we get rid of that stuff. It's not good. If you'd like more videos on foot and ankle, click the link above. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our YouTube channel right here. Hit that bell for notifications so you know when we post new videos. We're doing them all the time. You don't want to miss this content. And we'll catch you on the next one.